time is it? It's time for you to get your press up! What's going on, guys? Coach Joe here at the Lion's Den, currently recovering from, you know, I call it a forced deload. Some people are calling it COVID these days. I don't know. But anyway, I'm back in action. I'm back. There's going to be lots of content consistently. I know I said it probably in the past before. This time I'm telling the truth. All those other times were lies. This one is the truth. But if you aren't subscribed to this channel, you're going to get a forced deload from me. In this video, we're diving into 5 tips to increase your overhead press. And in this gym, you know, I'm the pressing king, the pressing master. I am the master shredder of the pressing. So let's dive into it. Tip number 1 is gonna be about grip. Okay, grip. In the past, I've heard that I said to go wide. Recently, I've been going pretty narrow, and I'm here to tell you that it really is up to you, okay? We like to use what's called the Goldilocks method. And I don't know if you guys have heard of Goldilocks, but I'm gonna tell you the whole story right now.
So there was this bear and there was a girl. Actually, I think there were a couple bears and one girl. That just sounds like a bad situation. So let's just not even get involved in it, actually.
Basically, what we wanna do is find what's just right for you. Typically, what I like to recommend is just starting with thumb on the knurling and then wrapping your hands around, okay? Seeing how that feels. I have actually been a little bit closer because I like to engage the triceps a little bit more in my press, and I like to keep everything close and compact when I press. Now, I used to probably press a little bit wider, but what I found for me is it caused me some shoulder pain, a little bit uncomfortable, and I also wasn't as strong. It wasn't the most efficient press for me. So for you guys, play around with it. I think you're gonna find that you may like a bit more narrow of a grip, or just kind of that thumb length away from the knurling. So give that a shot, but basically we want what's gonna be most efficient for you and what's gonna keep you as tight and compact as possible. Obviously we have some different arm lengths, right? We got just different builds. So it's gonna be the Goldilocks method. But what I would say to probably avoid is going super wide, okay, or super narrow. All right, tip number 2 when it comes to getting a sick overhead press, my whippersnappers, is going to be do not press the bar in front of you. Okay, when we press the bar out in front of us, we are away from center mass. It's gonna make the press just feel heavier and it's not gonna be as efficient, all right? If we press and we get our head through, and basically my cue for that is kind of keeping your ear in line with your bicep, we're gonna have a good amount of supporting contact points going from our wrist to our elbow to our shoulder and all the way down our entire body. And we're also going to just be more efficient because it's going to be in line with center mass. We don't want to overextend our head through, okay? So I'll show examples of this, but basically just press the bar up, okay? Getting your head tucked back and out of the way, and then bringing your head through as you press, and it's going to just make it more efficient. And often when people are pressing and I see them maybe get stuck, I tell them to get their head through right away. And for some reason that typically helps get them through the press or a sticky point and just have a nice successful press. Tip number 3. For becoming master shredder presser is going to be do not breathe while we are pressing. You really don't want to breathe during any lifts, to be honest with you. And I've talked about this a numerous amount of times. So if you're just catching up, we're going to go through it one more time.
Here's an example. You have a water bottle, right? The water bottle is going to be your body. Now, if we put the cap on really tight, we squeeze it, nothing comes out. It's nice and solid. That's your body when you have air. Okay? Stuff is inside of it. We loosen the cap, we squeeze it with pressure, all the water falls out, or air, whatever. That's your body while you're breathing, when you're pressing or doing any lift. We want to keep as much pressure built up in our body as possible. So when you're doing the press, there are only 2 times you should breathe while you're pressing. That is either going to be at the top between the reps or at the bottom between reps. So do not breathe air out as you are pressing. Keep everything nice, tight, and compact. If your face starts turning blue, and you feel like you're going to pass out or possibly die, maybe you should breathe.
All right, tip number 4, master shredder press, is stance. You're like, what? This is our shoulders. Why are we talking about our feet? Because it matters. Why it matters? It's because if we're super narrow and we're walking on a tightrope when we press, it's gonna leave us a lot of instability, okay? So we wanna have a nice, strong base. Let's think about a pyramid, right? The pyramid has a nice, wide base. It's a very strong structure. We're gonna do the same thing with our base, which is our feet. So when we're pressing, we wanna have our feet about shoulder or hip width. Once again, Goldilocks. Don't get me started on that fable again. But find what's comfortable for you. But I would say it's not gonna be super wide and it's not gonna be super narrow. It's gonna be just right. And when we're pressing, remember, we want a nice even surface with our feet. So having all points of contact from our foot to the ground. And as you're pressing, another little side tip here, it's gonna be squeezing your
booty, baby.
And keeping that booty nice and squeezed, which is just gonna keep more of that base rooted into the ground and give you a nice strong structure to press from. Number five, my favorite number growing up, and that's why it's important, is going to be gear. It's not essential, okay, but it's something we do want to talk about because it's something that can aid in your lifting. It's something that a lot of lifters here use and I use. So when we're pressing, first thing I'd recommend is going to be some wrist wraps. Okay, wrist wraps are going to be great just for keeping just more support and structure in the wrist when you're pressing. From there, elbow sleeves, okay? Find a pair of elbow sleeves or a brand that you like that fits well. It should be tight and you should feel that compression. Some elbow sleeves are gonna be thicker than others, which may allow for a little bit of spring and kind of bounce to them. It all depends on what kind of strength sport you compete in and what kind of lifter you are, but that could be of aid to you. From there, we always recommend belts. I've made a whole video on belts. I'll link up right up here. Check the belt video out. And then if you are doing some sort of pressing that involves any leg drive, maybe some knee sleeves would be of use to you. And then lastly, shoes. When it comes to shoes, I recommend a flat shoe. So something like a Metcon, a Nano, Vans, Chucks, whatever is comfortable, it's flat, so we can get that good foot contact point on the floor. Or a weightlifting shoe. I preferably like to use weightlifting shoes. So that's up to you guys to decide. But like I said, not essential. You don't need to go out and buy all this stuff right now, but in your journey, it's probably good to have some of these tools and some of this gear to help you progress in your lifting journey. All right, guys, hopefully you enjoyed the pressing tip video. Some of these were repeated from other pressing videos that I put out that I've just been letting circulate throughout this video, but check all those out. Lots of content in there. I've increased my overhead press a lot over the last couple of years, put a lot of time in trying to figure out this lift. So I wanna give you guys tons of value. We also have released a press specific program. It's 12 week long and it's plug and play with whatever press you wanna increase the most, but it does have an emphasis on the press. So if you guys are looking to increase that, I highly recommend checking it out. It's very affordable. So get on that now. We also have the Iron Lions Facebook group. Just type in the Iron Lions in the Facebook search bar for our Facebook group, which is a free community for you guys to join where we do form checks. We put in articles, we put in videos specifically just for that group. It's a little secret community that has a lot of kick-ass people in there. So join that group, check out the press program and all the other program templates that we have. If you guys want coaching, et cetera, from anybody here or myself, we really appreciate the support, especially during these tough times. But until then, stay a lean, mean strength machine. Right? I'm talking about testosterone, deca, trenbolone, masteron, oxandrolone, progesterone, a sloppy joe alone, a chicken tenderloin. We're still rolling? Damn. All right. Wait, what was the... Oh, gear. All right. Actually talking about gear.